Good morning, students. The topic for my today's presentation is biotechnological application in medicine. Under this topic, we will cover the use of insulin as a medicine. In the market, there are so many medicines are available. Have you ever think about from where these medicines come from? The source of these medicines is microorganisms, plants, and even the animals. So these medicines sometimes cause immunological ill effects. That means something bad effect on the human health. So to overcome those bad effects, biotechnology help in the production of recombinant medicines. So what are recombinant medicines? Recombinant means something that is made by recombination. So first medicine that was prepared with the help of biotechnology, that was the insulin. So insulin is a polypeptide hormone produced by beta cells of the islets of Langerhans in the pancreas. Its main function is that the cells can take up glucose and convert into energy. And the deficiency of insulin causes the disease. The name of that disease is diabetes. In this slide, you can see on my left hand side there is pancreas. From the pancreas, if we cut the section of pancreas, on my right hand side there are the islets of Langerhans that contain the beta cells, that is purple in the color. Those beta cells secrete the insulin, that brown small parts, they are the insulin, and that insulin help the cells. There is a cell, is the muscle cell, which is unable to take the glucose, and that glucose is converted into energy. So when this insulin is absent in our body, then this glucose is not converted into energy. So that disease is known as the diabetes. In this slide, you can see the structure of insulin. Insulin is made up of two chains, alpha chain and beta chain, and both are joined together with the disulfide bond. Insulin is made up of two peptide chains referred to as alpha chain and beta chain. Alpha and beta chain are linked together by disulfide bonds, and an additional disulfide is found within the alpha chain. Alpha chain consists of 21 amino acids and beta chain of 30 amino acids. So the total amino acids are the 51 in the insulin. Insulin used for diabetes was earlier extracted from the pancreas of slaughtered cattle and pigs. But this insulin was not effective, and sometimes it caused the ill effects on the health of the patient also. So biotechnology help in the production of recombinant human insulin, a form of insulin made from recombinant DNA, which is human insulin. So it is made up of three chains, chain A, chain B, and chain C. Now, what will happen that this insulin sometimes is not secreted from the pancreas. So, when this is not secreted in our body, then it cause a disease, as I have already told, diabetes. So if we will give some artificial insulin to a patient who is suffering from the diabetes, then he can use glucose as a energy. So this, you can say, this artificial insulin or recombinant insulin was first prepared by the scientist. The name of those scientists is the Bantin and students, in this slide you can see how we can prepare the human insulin or recombinant insulin with the help of biotechnology. So on my left hand side you can see there is a cell. That cell is known as the human pancreatic cell, that is taken from the pancreas of the human. And in that cell you can see red color DNA, and that DNA, as I've already told you, that DNA is a very long string. We don't need that whole DNA. We are interested only in a particular part of DNA or a segment of DNA. That segment of DNA is known as the gene. So we are interested in a gene or segment of DNA which is encoding for the insulin. So we cut that DNA and we separate the human gene that is encoding for the insulin. Now this gene we will recombine it with the plasmid. From where this plasmid will come? The plasmid will come from the bacteria. You can see on left hand side, on lower side, there is bacteria. Bacteria contain two types of DNA, bacterial DNA and plasmid DNA. What will we are interested? We are interested in the plasmid DNA. We will take that plasmid DNA from the bacteria, and that we will cut with the help of restriction enzyme that bacteria plasmid, and in the cut we will join that gene, that is a segment of DNA. So this is recombinant because we have rejoined it with the plasmid. Now this is the recombinant DNA. What we will do next step, we will put this recombinant DNA in a bacteria, right? And that recombinant DNA in a bacteria will start multiplying. Now why we insert it in bacteria only, why not in human or animal? Because bacteria multiply very fast. How they multiply? 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16, 16 to 32, and so on. So because they multiply very fast, so if they will multiply, our recombinant DNA will multiply. If our recombinant DNA will multiply, our insulin will multiply, because we need insulin at very huge amount or very high amount of DNA. So what we will do, we will transfer those bacteria into a fermenter. And how in fermenter these bacteria multiply, what types of fermenters are there, that we'll discuss in our next presentations. So in the fermenter, those bacteria started multiplying, and as they are multiply, the insulin will multiply, and that insulin we can use as a normal insulin. So it we can give it to the patient, and we will treat the diabetes, because it will act in the human body as the normal insulin works in the human body. And students, today we have learned how biotechnology help in the production of recombinant medicines, especially the insulin. For further query, you please contact me at fullerani@yahoo.co.in. Thank you.